everybody, this is Cappy Smack coming to you from Elite Dangerous on the Xbox, where I'm not yet elite, and sometimes I'm not even dangerous. But what I am doing is getting my fuel skid so I can head down to Bellic. So I spent a little bit of time doing a couple jobs. I'm up to, I might have almost a million once I turn this job in. Just need a fuel scoop, which is about 285k. And then I'm gonna head down to Bellis and see what's happening down there so I can run some passenger missions. Alright, so I've got almost a million. All my jobs are done. Let me clear out some expenses. Alright, looks like I need to get me a cheap ship. I think I'm gonna just ride with the Clover Bounty. Not gonna worry about that. Let me see if I can outfit my ship. Get it set up for doing passenger missions. And we'll see if I can do any kind of money making activity in game right now. I may be interrupted because I ordered some food from Amazon Prime now. Shameless plug. Alright, fuel scoop. I have enough. I transferred my economy passenger cabins from where I bought them. Man, yeah, I'm gonna be shieldless. But I'll be able to take 24 passengers. No shields, 24 passengers. And I have my fuel scoop, and I think I'm good to go. Let's just see if I have enough money to buy a couple of weapons. Not really here. So the answer is kind of no. Alright. So I'm looking at maybe about 10 jumps. And let's go do it. So I'm going to try to do the Bellis 8 run.
Clear the landing pad at regulate speed until outside the exclusion zone.
I'm not going to record setting up each run. I'm just going to show you where it is, head out there. You know, my ship's good. Generally takes about an hour to set up a run, and run takes about 20 minutes. I'm not worried with any of that. It's So there's Bellis. I think I'm going to label this. Alright, I like that. And we'll take a look at how many jumps. 13 jumps. Let's see how I got my settings. 20 light year max. Alright. Alright, can't really do anything with that. Oh wait, I need to make sure I've got scoopable stars. I do not. So now I'm going to set this up for scoopable stars. Star class. Just give me the scoopables. Main sequence is everything including L1 above. Those are the only ones I can scoop. Probably would have hit main sequence stars the whole way. Setting that filter just ensures that any star I jump to is going to be main sequence. Maybe except for that one. Because now I think I need to reset my route. See what that does for me. M class is scoopable. I don't really need fuel right now, but I do like to scoop when I can. Technically, I might only need to scoop once. Scooping every star you can scoop also reduces the amount of time you have to spend scooping. Otherwise, you're going to sit around for quite a bit of time to fill up your tank. I'm going to spend a bit of time here. I can either hang around the bottom of the planet and just thrust around the bottom of the star. this thruster mount over. I can keep it partially in my view. And then thrust around. Try to keep the exclusion zone marker lined up with the right reticle marker. Of course, if you go into the exclusion zone, you're going to stop and burn until you put out the fire. Because stars are hot. Now, I don't have an advanced scanner, so honking isn't going to help me a lot. And if you engage your jump drive when you're too close to a star, you can heat up. Just like I did right there.
Frameshift drive charging.
8 more jumps to Bellis. And believe it or not, this too is part of the grind. In fact, if you want to unlock Professor Phelan, you're going to be doing this a lot. Jumping and honking and scooping. Probably going to be doing it in Aspen's Folder. What you're going to be doing it for 5,000 lightning. Because I did that on the PlayStation 4. And it took a couple days. And it's pretty dull and boring. Phelan doesn't do that much for you. Used to be you could unlock Professor Phelan and you get jobs to go collect Thargoid stuff for 10 mil a pop. But then the station where that job was given out was attacked. I gotta wait for it to be repaired or the Thargoids to move on. The winds of fortune to change. Well, that sounds bad. As long as the temperature is under 100%, really not a big deal. Thank you. Oh, this is the last main sequence storm in Designated Route. Well, that's a nice little message to pop up. Four more jumps. So I have to fill up here. Because there'll be no more main sequence stars until I get to Bellis. That's only four more jumps. I will check stellar cartography just to see. And it looks like I can pretty easily make it. Let me just double check. Yep, that's Bellis. Oh, alright. Yeah, I should be able to make it.
Frameshift drive charging.
Well, that's a Class K. I should be able to scoop that one.
Ready to engage.
So I'm not sure why it was popping that message up. Like the very next star on my route is suitable. Unless the game considers Class K not to be main sequence, but I think it is. Class L, Ground Dwarf, probably not going to be scoopable. Yeah, I think I need to uncheck Class L. Yep, I'm gonna uncheck Class L. Not main sequence.
Frameshift drive charging.
Although Red Giant should be. But there's Bellis, so I'm just gonna head on over to Bellis. Scoop as I go past the star a little bit. Don't worry about it. Just need to go to Tomba platform. More than enough fuel. Alright, do I need to scan? I think I might need to get over the nav. Nav point. Oh, there's Tomba. And I'll transfer some gear so I can gain some local rep. Because being allied means I make more money. Although, any kind of money in the beginning is going to be more than welcome. Oh, there's the entrance. Just need to get oriented correctly. Now this is the run that I was doing on the PlayStation when I went to Trade Elite. So it can be a really good way to gain Trade Elite status. And I was able to make more than enough money to get the Federal Corvette and very soon a Cutter. Of course, it also gave me an Imperial Courier and an Imperial Clipper. Excuse me. Look, Ma, no shields. Let's see what we got. Just going to reconnoiter the missions. Don't think I'm going to take any right now because I want to switch over and do something else. But 17 aid workers. It's going to the wrong place, but still 44k for me right now is not bad. And I'm looking for Hayden. Anybody going to Hayden? Don't really see any quite yet, so I would be board flipping until I find them. So you pick up passengers at Tomba, you take them into Hayden. It's about a 20-minute run. And so I'm going to end this episode. Be sure to like, subscribe, and share. If you want to check me out on Patreon and help me with my medical expenses, I've got an L4 herniated disc, and I'm trying to take care of that. That would be appreciated. So we'll catch you next time. In the meantime, fly safe.